Hi, my name is Ben. I work for Murrelektronik. Today, we will learn how to set up a Cube67 Plus Ethernet IP station and configure some digital and analog signals. Connect your PC to the Cube system and open the web server in your browser. Click on the Parameters tab to modify the IP address of the Cube station. Save the changes and restart the bus node. Now we're going to add modules to the system and show you how to work with placeholders. Add the virtual module named System State. This module informs the PLC about the current state of the bus node. The assembly pair is 100-112. Add the Virtual Diagnostics module. This module transmits process data diagnostic messages to the PLC. Here, you can choose how many diagnostic messages the system provides in the process data. Each diagnostic message has 8 bytes. You can have maximum 16 diagnostic messages. Add the 56601 module to the first position in branch 0. This is slot 001. Add the 56731 module to the first position in branch 1. This is slot 101. Add a placeholder module. A placeholder is a virtual module with configurable input and output data lengths. It fills gaps between modules or reserves a space for a module to be added at a later stage. Here, we will configure it as an input-output device with 2 bytes each. Add the 56766 module to the first position in branch 2. This is slot 201. We can edit any module that has already been created. As an example, let's change the input and output address of the 56766 to the placeholder we created before. The placeholder is replaced by the module and disappears from the list. When we delete a created module, it is replaced by a placeholder. To continue the setup, we will insert the 56601 again. If later in the configuration you want to use the I/O link ports of the module, you need to reserve the bytes here. In this case, 10 input bytes and 10 output bytes. You can select different types of entries in the list, including the topology view or the input or output data view. Now we will start to configure the modules. 56601 is a multifunctional module with 16 digital signals on 8 ports. We want both signals on port 0 to 3 to be outputs. Both signals on ports 4 to 7 are supposed to be inputs, the default setting, so we don't need to change a thing. Save the configuration. Using the I/O overview tab, we can set the value for the digital outputs and monitor the configured digital inputs. Click on Refresh to monitor the module inputs. The active ones will change to green. Go to the next module and open the Parameters tab. 56731 is an analog input module with 4 signals. We want to work with 4 to 20 milliamps analog signals on port 0 and 0 to 20 milliamps on port 1. If necessary, you can edit the default values of the diagnostic levels. Save the configuration. Using the I/O overview tab, you can monitor the current values of the analog inputs. go to the next module and open the Parameters tab. 56766 is a 4-port I/O link master, but we are only using the digital signals in this example. We want both signals on port 0 to 1 to be outputs, so we need to change the configuration again. Click on Save. Well done, that's it. The configuration is now saved in the bus node. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, visit www.murrelektronik.com to find your contact person.